Happy Monday. This is Magical Michelle, and welcome to Living Magically. This week's energy and astrological forecast for the week of October 23rd. We've got a lot going on, and so let's get through a few of the little things that I wanted to share with you first. First off, I want to thank Marissa Bailey for making one of my personal dreams come true. And that is that we are now a full live podcast. So we will be continuing to stream this live on Mondays for the near future, on Mondays in the Soul Circle Facebook group. So if you want to watch this live in with my beautiful face, please feel free to subscribe to the Soul Circle Facebook group. And if that isn't good for you, if it isn't convenient, we will also be continuing to put this as a video onto our YouTube channel. But I have answered your request, and we are now able to also bring this to you as a podcast. So many ways to receive this message, and from now on, it will be in all of those different places. How you could help me is to like and subscribe so I can continue to bring you all the news. And what I do, if you happen to be new to me, is that every week I come forward, and I've been doing this now since 2017, just only on Facebook. I bring forward what is going on astrologically, the big event of the week, sometimes more than one, and then I share how you can energetically transmit this energy and transmute it and make it yours and bring good information toward how to sort of navigate the energy and how to make it your best week every single week. So we're going to start with the obvious for this week, which is the Taurus lunar eclipse. And it is the big, big energy. And if you've been navigating the eclipses, you might already know that we are in between the solar eclipse that happened a week ago and this big astrological new moon. I'm sorry, we had the new moon, and now we're at the full moon in Taurus. And it's Saturday the 28th, and it will be happening in the afternoon for most of us, if you're Eastern Standard Time. And it's big energy. It is popping the energy of Taurus, which is ruled by Venus, and she rules things like stability and money, and she rules all of the things that Tauruses are known for and Venus is known for, like your food, your home, love, beauty. There's a lot of energy about relationships, and it is the last of the Taurus eclipses. We've been doing this for 2 years now. And so you'll see this theme for the next 6 months until we hit the next eclipse cycle. The good news is that you will see the eclipses over at the end of this week, and you'll be out of the eclipse portal in about 2 more weeks. So those of you who have been feeling it know that it is going to stabilize shortly, and you'll be seeing the after effects of this at a 30-day mark and a 60-day mark. So what do you do to make it your best eclipse possible? In fact, sometimes with my friends, I'll even say, may the eclipse be with you. And when it is with you, it means you are using the energy to help forward your dreams. To, instead of getting all upset, the first thing I want to say is take a few minutes and pause whenever you feel extra emotion right now. It's intense. Yes, we've all been feeling it. We've been feeling it for a month now, and especially since that solar eclipse on the 14th. So we're in what they call the liminal in between, because eclipses travel in pairs. They travel new moon and full moon, or a full moon, then a new moon. And sometimes it even has a third eclipse at a time, but there's always two, sometimes three. Lucky us, we only have two. So we are over halfway through that liminal in between, where big change happens in between these two eclipses. It's whatever is being called to be transformed in your life. What area does that hit you? Are you looking to make an income leap, a career leap, stabilize your relationship, find a new relationship, better your relationship, change your relationship with food, change your relationship with money? Wherever you are looking to stabilize and transform a relationship, this is what's going to be happening for you right now. And it's an overarching theme throughout the planet, throughout the world. And you start with yourself. I just taught a class this weekend, and one of the things that came through was the idea of making sure you're in right relationship with yourself. Are you your own best friend? Are you treating yourself the way you want others to treat you? Are you in love with yourself? And are you in love with your life? If there's any area that isn't true for you, now is a time to make deep transformative changes. And sometimes that just means acknowledging it. Start by deciding what it is you're going to be doing, changing, and growing from. And then the second thing is to stabilize. Get yourself grounded. Earth signs like Taurus like to be grounded on real live matters, planet Earth matters. Taurus is a fixed sign, but we have moved into Scorpio season, which is a water sign. So there's all the feels. And this is the beginning of what we call Samhain. Halloween is another term that we've used in America at this time, but Samhain is the ancient traditional name for this season that is halfway between the autumn equinox and the winter solstice. And so this is the time. Scorpio season is death, rebirth, transformation, and change. Taurus is structure and stability and grounding. So in this time of death, rebirth, and change, you're looking for structure, stability, and love. So how do you love yourself more? How do you deepen that practice? How do you come into right relationship with yourself and then create that sacred circle of people that you are surrounded with, that stabilize you, that nurture you, that support you? And if you don't have that inner circle, it's time to start moving to a place where you first find it within yourself and then bring it forward and share it with other people. It's sometimes a process, but now is the time, and the time is now. We're gonna see this theme going on all the way through the true astrological Samhain, which happens to fall on 11/11 this year. So 11/11 is this year's 15 degrees of Scorpio. It also happens to be the weekend I'm running Witchy Weekend in New Smyrna Beach. So I have two spaces available. However, this is literally the last week you can sign up for it. So if this is something you want to do, you want to be in ritual, you want to be in community, you want to be wined and dined, actually no wine, at the beautiful anchor in bed and breakfast in New Smyrna Beach, you will be treated to a transformational experience, which includes a powerful ritual circle directly on the ocean, as long as we have the weather and the turtles are all ready to go, we will be doing this ritual directly on the beach side on 11/11 evening. But it runs that whole weekend, and it is the fourth year we've been doing this. Wow, I can't believe how fast time really moves. It is one of my favorite events of the year, and we won't be doing it next year because of scheduling and some other things that are happening with my travel. So if you've been waiting to come to Witchy Weekend, or you've never heard of Witchy Weekend and you want to be supported right now in this transformational process by being in community and magic, we'll drop a link here in the comment section for you to go check that out. In the meantime, this is also a good time for you to ritualize whatever work you're doing personally. I really like writing out your intentions, and because it is death, we look at the releasing process. We write it out, what you're letting go of, and I release this with grace and ease and love and joy, the things that no longer serve me. And you can rip it up, and that takes the energy out of it, or you can ball it up in a ball and energetically throw it in the trash. Or you can burn it, which is that phoenix fire transformative process. That's my favorite way, is actually write out what you're letting go of and claim that if you haven't learned the lesson, that what is happening is trying to teach you, that instead you can learn the lesson in a clearer way, one that's more pleasant and opens your heart. So letting something go. And then, because it is a full moon and there is a lot of energy, I would actually start writing, dreaming, and visualizing, where do you want to be in the next 3 months, 6 months, 6 years? Now is a perfect time to tap into that bigger picture of where do you want to be? Where do you want your relationship with yourself to be? Where do you want your romantic relationship to be? Where do you want your friends, family, coworkers, and your relationship to be? Where do you want your relationship with your money to be? And where do you want your relationship with your physical body to be? Where do you want your relationship with your home to be? And you can see where I'm going with this. And you can write that out, and you can put it on a candle. You could light a candle and place the piece of paper underneath. You can write this into a journal. Or again, my favorite way is to actually place this in a fire and state, I call these things to me with grace and ease and love and joy. And I ignite my own heart and the energy to bring this alive into the creative life force energy. And I actually state it as I already have it. I am so, so grateful. I am so thankful that this is already mine. So you want to state it as it is already done. And you want to be connecting to the gratitude and even the senses of having it. So when you are connecting to the senses, what does that experience smell like? What does that feel like physically, like the visceral touch? What does it sound like? What does it look like? And what does it taste like? So I actually anchor in the emotions, which then create a state. And that state is that of already having it or the one who already has something. And this therefore creates a magnetic field and an expectation that you're expecting it, and it is magnified to you, and it is arriving to you with grace and ease and love and joy. So this is what I would do this week and throughout the season, all the way through the 11/11 portal. If you want to know more about Samhain, we will be discussing that next Monday. But if you want to attack this particular eclipse with the right energy, I would go at it stabilizing yourself, taking a little bit of time to yourself, and making sure you remember that kindness, compassion, and maybe just an even a pause before you react to something is going to be the right action to take. Right now, there is definitely a review going on. You're reviewing where you are, and more importantly, you're reviewing where you've been and letting it go, and you're reviewing where you are and where you want to be, and you're claiming it, you're owning it, and you're connecting to the version of you that already has it in a way that is already grateful for it with the law of expectation. So if you are looking for more information, you want to connect with me, I have a website called magicalmichelle.com, and I look forward to working with you in the future, and I'll see you again next week. Remember to live magically.